What's up, Tweenerheads, and welcome back to another Tweenerhead Tennis video. And today we have more information about the Justin Gimelstob incident. Now, we have been talking to one of our sources. Yes, we have a source in the tennis community who talks more about what's been going on in Justin Gimelstob's life to kind of reach the tipping point of what happened during the incident of him. If you don't know what happened at the beginning of Justin Gimelstob, a quick recap. He was arrested for beating someone up viciously during an on-court incident at a country club where he beat someone more than 50 times, where he almost killed a man and was arrested and then later bailed on a $50,000 bailout fee. Now, if you want to see more information about what happened, I'll leave a link in the description below to find for the full story that you guys can follow through. But right now, we are going to talk about more of what we learned from our source of what happened. From what we were talking about yesterday, we found out that not everything was going perfectly well for Justin. Unfortunately, his father recently passed away unexpectedly, and my condolences to him and his family for what happened. That was probably something that was still boiling inside of him, and something that was happening as well. As there's nothing you can say about that when you have a death in the family, so my condolences to him. There's nothing you can really say, so my condolences to him and his family. He's also taking care of his mother as well, who's still recovering from the death of his father, and that's something else that he's put on the weight of his shoulders. If we go back to the incident that happened at the country club as well, we were told that during this incident that the person that was beaten by Justin was egging him on. Now, I don't know what was said or what words were exchanged, but from my source, they said that Justin was egged on multiple times and on multiple occasions, apparently, that forced him to come over and encounter this man that was saying some really, really awful stuff. On another note, when it comes to his estranged wife who filed a restraining order some time ago, they've been going through a pretty bad divorce where both of them are still not officially divorced and both of them are seeing a different person at this time. Now, I'm not going to name any names or who gave me these sources, but this divorce and custody battle has been going on for 3 long years. Yes, 3 years. And I imagine the amount of pressure that's been going on in his life. So I really can't know what's going on in his head, what's going on throughout this entire process, but I'm just letting you guys up to date of what the information we're getting is and what is going on with this situation. If we look at his tennis channel anchor position, it looks like he's not going to come back to the tennis channel at all. It looks like he's probably going to stay away from that, or he's not going to return, because like I said in my last video, tennis is just such a clean-cut sport, and I'm seeing him coming back to his position as an anchor. I bet they do not want to have someone like that, or even reference to an incident like that, to come back and commentate on tennis. And that's just my point of view and what my source says as well. What's interesting about this incident is that a lot of people don't know who Justin Gimelstob is. He did win a couple of Grand Slams with Venus Williams in mixed doubles. But if this was a different scenario, say a top 10 singles player was involved, technically John Isner is, but not that he did this, not that he was directly involved, like he was the person beating him. But when it comes to a Grand Slam champion, he is a champion in a sense of mixed doubles, but if this was someone bigger, it would be a whole different story. If you look at different incidents like in the NFL that I mentioned in my last video, if you like Kareem Hunt recently is never going to be touched again in the NFL. And now this is kind of that scenario of violent actions and what's going to happen next. So I really think Justin Gimelstob's not going to come back into the tennis world, at least as a commentator. As a coach, on the other hand, John Isner's probably telling him that he messed up, didn't do well, he fucked up really badly, he really did. And that he's probably going to take some time off. But that's just a personal coaching choice on John Isner's part. Whether or not he's going to continue with his help, I don't know. That's his own case. But he probably could coach again, because that's just a personal choice on the player's hand. But in terms of a professional ATP board, tennis anchor, he's probably going to be removed from those positions. So yeah, I'm just letting you guys up to date with more information of what we're learning about the Justin Gimelstob incident. If you want to find out more, make sure to subscribe to Tweenerhead Tennis and hit that bell so that way you get notifications turned on. So every time we post a video, you'll get to know. If you want to follow us on all our behind the scenes content as well at tweenerheadtennis.com. If you want to find some cool Tweenerhead Tennis merchandise, some hoodies, some t-shirts, some stickers, make sure to check those out. And follow us on all our social medias, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Make sure to check out all those. So stay up to date with our latest content by subscribing to Tweenerhead Tennis and leave a like on this video. Hope to see you guys soon. Thanks, guys.